Thank you, Sihle. Now, our inspiring youth for this week is Dr Sivuyile Madikana, medical doctor and health advocate. His list of accolades include being awarded the South African Medical Association as Junior Doctor of the Year, Mail and Guardian Top 200 Influential Young South African and Health Excellence Special Award at the Gauteng Youth Excellence Awards, just to mention a few. Our reporter Thapelo Mowela sat down with him and asked him about his love for medicine and where it all began. This is what he had to say.
And my dad used to work in a hospital as well. So I kind of grew up in an environment where there was a medical kind of, you know, nuance like in the background all the time. And I've always wanted to help people. I just didn't know. So when I was growing up, I thought, okay, fine, maybe like let me do this medicine thing. And then I saw they were like, yo, marks, you need to be like high, like extremely high. And I know I wasn't getting the marks at the time, and I thought to myself, I would never make it, you know. But then came to high school, I was working really hard, I was doing a lot. And I remember reading an article in one of the newspapers at the time, and they were saying that in like medical schools don't just want people that have like straight A's, but they want people who are intelligent, but also people that are caring, and also how they look at your whole entire life, what do you do.
Dr. Sivuyile Madikana is passionate about healthcare in Africa, youth development, service and advocacy. He is a Master of Public Health candidate at the New York University Global College of Public Health, specializing in healthcare management and policy.
I am the first doctor in our family, and for them it was, I suppose, a dream come true for them to see the child that they've raised becoming something that they've always wanted to see in their children or even other children.
You hold a medical degree and you mainly focus on HIV research and advocacy in young women. Why those two?
We're taught very much to be clinical but also advocates of the health that we speak about. And I started working with a campaign called Brothers for Life a few years ago. And what that taught me is that I could be an advocate to young people and young men around the country, because I have a platform and I might as well use it for good. And so it became a special interest topic for me, and also sort of a passion project as well, that we must continue educating people but using the digital tools and social media tools that we have. And that's how my interest has been sparked.
Recently moved to New York and you're part of the UN. What is your role there? What exactly do you do?
I'm a medical doctor, so I did an MBBCH at Wits, and I did a Master's in Business Administration at Wits as well, with a special research focus on the digitization of healthcare and how we can use digital tools and technology and innovation to kind of improve the healthcare systems in South Africa. And then I then moved to New York University, where I'm currently a Master's of Public Health candidate at the Global College of Public Health. And my specialization there is healthcare management and healthcare policy. And through that, I got a job at UN Women, where I work in the policy and governance division, and specifically working in health, gender equality, and HIV. So currently, my role at the UN is as a researcher, as working with the team, and we're working on a project on how we can use digital communication to improve in terms of the uptake and knowledge around HIV for young and adolescent girls in developing countries.
Currently, he owns and manages a health initiative called Hashtag Varsity Convos, which is aimed at institutions of higher learning. This initiative was born in 2017, makes use of both digital media and live discussion to facilitate positive conversation about health, especially HIV and AIDS, social justice and various issues affecting the student population. Popular tweeting sessions that occur twice a month were dubbed Hashtag Ask Dr. Sivu.
It's great and all to have platforms, but the access that you have to people and to able to influence people around you, that's what I always stand for. So that's kind of like my passion in terms of changing the world around me, because we've got a lot of things going on. We come from post-apartheid South Africa. We all know that everything is not great and dandy. We have a health system that's burdened in terms of the public health, and I'm trying to use my voice to kind of reduce that burden that the public healthcare system has, but also use my voice as an advocate, to use my voice to kind of change the world around me and the people around me for the better.
What was your biggest dreams when you were young, and would you say you've achieved those?
I know for myself, my goals continue to shift. The more I achieve and the more I do, the goalpost keeps on moving. And I really just want every young South African to see the potential within themselves and that they're able to really chase after their dreams. I always talk about chasing after your dreams, and that your dreams, when they finally become reality, that's a great feeling. I don't ever take no for an answer, and I continually work in that direction. So every young South African, I feel, should do the same. Don't take no for an answer. If you're knocking on one door, if that door closes, continue knocking. If that door does not open, there's another door at the back. So that's how I always kind of view things, and I view life, in that there's always a possibility to do more, to always be more, and to continually grow.